The room was priceless, for many of the objects could not be found for a second time period, and so the brothers spent their evenings and weekends among their much loved objects of art and tried to make still more perfect that which was already perfection period. It was not often, as we have said, that Mr. Wells left his house with neither his brother nor Miss Black in it, period. But on that night he had done so, period. Work hard kept him late in the city, and his brother had not been well and had gone away to have a small but necessary operations, period. Miss Black had left at 5:30 as usual, period. Mr. Wells read his paper while waiting for the 8:45 train home, but the train was late in starting as there was some mist in places along the line, comma, and it stopped several times before reaching his station, period. He got out and walked towards his home, period. The mist in the air seemed to have a red touch, he thought, as he walked on, period. Then he had a feeling of fear, of cold fear, for without doubt something was on fire, something was burning, period. He broke into a run and then he stopped, period. After all, it was not his house that was on fire, his own most beautiful and loved house, period. It was the house immediately behind his, period. But at the moment of his fear, he saw his life clearly for the first time, period. He saw that he had spent his years loving cold and lifeless objects, period. He saw that he loved no living being, and that no living being loved him or cared that he was late home that night, that he was cold and had known fear, period.